time ago, I used to be like these people, sitting in lumbers just camping chickens and cows. But eventually I leveled up, and I gained a little bit more experience. These days, I can struggle my way through most bosses, but not anything endgame, because I really don't know what I'm doing. In this series, I want to change that. So I decided that I'm going to kill every boss in this game. I've got a few objectives for this series. I want to gain confidence in every boss that currently exists, as well as any future ones. I want to master that boss's mechanics and be able to complete fights even if put under stressful situations. I'm also going to upgrade my gear as I go. I just want to get better at this game, and this is kind of a series to document that. And to help me get better, there's definitely some gear upgrades I need to get. On screen here, you can see a list of all of the weapons and gear that I want to obtain in this series. There's going to be a lot more than this, but this is a really good starting point. In this episode specifically, to prepare for the next boss I want to learn, I'm aiming to get both the main hand and offhand ascension crossbows. As I'm able to get things on this list, they'll be ticked off with a green check mark, and we'll move on to the next one. So I decided to master one boss at a time, starting with Vindicta. I'm starting with 1726 KC. I have both boss pets and the title for all of the drops completed on this boss. But my kill times have always kind of sucked, and I really want to master my ability rotation. My quickest kill time was 1:02, but I believe that was in a duo back in the day, so I've definitely got a lot of room for improvement.
Damn, I just got a 45 second kill. That's my new personal best.
That's a lance in like 35 kills. What?
Bro, are you freaking kidding me? That's another one like 20 kills later. What the hell's happening?
You know, by my own standards, the kills are pretty good, but like I'm consistently averaging right around 1 minute, and I'm still trying to figure out what rotation I was using when I got that 45 second kill. I mean, I know it was mostly just luck, but still.
All right, those dormant anima core legs coming in, I guess that's fine. I mean, I really can't complain. Like, in 30 kills, I got literally 2 lances, so whatever. I think this is our first Zerosian essence, to be honest. It's kind of surprising.
That one was pretty freaking close, 53 seconds. That, I am pretty proud of that. Not quite 45 seconds like we had yesterday, I think it was, but we're getting there. My rotations are feeling a lot more dialed in now. I mean, they're nowhere near perfect, believe me, but come on, another dormant body. I haven't seen a crest since I started this. I mean, I guess I'm pretty early into it, but still.
Of course, with 3 minutes left on my freaking aura. Oh my God. Well, whatever, that's the end of the hour. I didn't get anything really cool except for I think it was the body and the one essence, so.
There's lance number 3 coming in. It looks so good on the ground. I love it. So this is the start of the third and last day on my journey of mastering Vindicta. I've got a few thoughts on how this has gone so far. So overall, I feel like I've got my ability rotations for melee down fairly well. It's definitely taught me a lot about things you should do and shouldn't do, such as like what abilities to use inside of a Zerk rotation, things like that. Overall, I feel like my 45 second kill time was pretty good. That's like over, what is that, like 17 second improvement from my personal record before starting this. And I had that personal record in a duo. I remember just like a month or two ago killing some Vindicta. I believe I was using like a magic setup though, and I was averaging about 1:30 kills. So I mean, at the end of the day, realistically, I've improved a whole lot, and I'm quite proud of that. I've also made a decent amount of money along the way, and hopefully today we can get some more drops. But overall, I think this was a good experience. I've definitely learned things, and I'm excited to get on to the next boss. Will I come back to Vindicta at some point in the future? Absolutely. I would definitely like to beat that personal time. This whole time that I've spent at Vindicta, really I was just chasing beating my personal best. And I think really that's what getting better is about. Just always trying to beat yourself in what you do. So I definitely liked this experience. It was a good learning experience, I guess. 48 seconds. Are you kidding me? That's so close.
All right, I think this is going to be my last hour. At this point, I'm pretty confident that I've mastered this boss. I know all of its mechanics. My kill times are consistently right around a minute. Sometimes I screw up and they're a little bit higher, but generally speaking, they're a minute or lower. I'm kind of hoping to get one more drop before I stop, just because I do have some equipment that I want to buy before the next episode, but we'll see if we can get there or not. According to my drop log here, I went through and withdrew everything out of my bank. This is what we are left with. The biggest, of course, being the three lances. We didn't see a crest in 300 kills, which is a little odd, but whatever. So if we go ahead and price check this, 194 mil. Right on. Okay, so I know exactly what I'm going to go do with that. So I am going to sell this and I will be back. So we sold everything. The lances actually sold for, I think it was like 2 mil more than they price checked at. So that was pretty cool. In total, we're ending with 201 mil. So what we're going to do is we're just going to chuck in an offer to buy the main hand ascension crossbow. Get one of those things checked off the list. Hopefully it will buy for 201 mil. All right, well, I guess we're just gonna let that chill there and see what happens. So we bought a whole bunch of stuff since that last clip. I ended up having to buy the Ascension crossbow at about 205 mil. I did have some extra money laying around and I sold a few things, but we also bought ourselves full normal Sirenic, some Pernix boots, and then we're just waiting for the gloves to buy. So I need to get all of this augmented, get all the perks I need on it. Yeah, in total, I would say this first episode was quite a success. I had a lot of fun doing this. I hope you had a lot of fun watching it. If you have any recommendations or suggestions, things I need to improve on that you've noticed, 100% let me know down below. I always love reading comments from people. Thank you so much for watching, everybody. I really appreciate it. If you like what you saw here, there will be plenty more episodes, so feel free to leave a like and subscribe. Otherwise, have a great rest of your day. Bye.